students, welcome back in our social science class. Students, today we will start our chapter 2, that is parallels and meridians. So here I am showing you a globe, a picture of globe. In this picture you can see number of lines running from north to south and east to west. Are these lines really drawn on our earth or map? No, they are only imaginary lines. What is imaginary lines? Do you know? Imaginary lines are a number of horizontal and vertical lines all over the globe or a map. These lines help us to find the exact location of a place on a globe or a map. Imaginary lines that run from east to west are called lines of latitude, parallels, and those that run from north to south are called lines of longitude or meridians. The parallels and meridians cut each other at right angle 90 degree. Now we will start our chapter. Equator. So equator is the longest parallel which divides the earth into two equal parts. These equal parts are called hemisphere. The part which is towards the north of equator is called the northern hemisphere. The part which is towards the south of the equator is called the southern hemisphere. Now we will move to our next topic, latitudes and longitudes. Just like a letter is able to reach your house through your address, a specific place on the map or on the globe can be located with the help of geographic coordinate system. The geographic coordinate of a place consists of the degrees of the latitude and longitudes. Latitudes or parallels are imaginary lines drawn parallels to the equator towards both the north and the south direction. They are measured from 0 degree to 90 degree in both hemisphere. The earth is round and so the length of the latitude decreases as we move towards the poles. Longitudes. Longitudes or meridians are the imaginary lines drawn between the two poles. They divide the earth in 360 equal segments like that of an orange. The 0 degree longitude passing through Greenwich in England is called the prime meridian. One half of the world is measured in 180 degree longitude of east, while the other half in 180 degree longitude of west. Both the latitudes and longitudes form a grid in which they intersect each other at right angles. So for locating a place on earth, you need to make the degrees of latitudes and longitudes. For example, city New Orleans is located at 30 degree north and 90 degree west. Remember one thing, although a few lines of latitudes and longitudes are shown on the globes and maps, their number is infinite. So a city can fall any one of this crossing. Now I am explaining you important parallels. Students, in the mid of the globe you can see a line. This line is called equator, and the line which is above the equator, that is known as the Tropic of Cancer. The line which is above the Tropic of Cancer, that is known as Arctic Circle. The line which is below the equator, that is known as Tropic of Capricorn. And the line which is below the Tropic of Capricorn, that is known as Antarctic Circle. So the total number of important parallel on the globe is 7, that is North Pole, Arctic Circle, ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर, इक्वेटर, ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैप्रिकॉन एंड अंटार्कटिक सर्कल. नाउ वी विल कंप्लीट आवर बुक एक्सरसाइजेस. चेक योर स्टडी. टिक द करेक्ट आंसर. द मेरिडियन विच पासिस थ्रू ग्रीनविच इज मार्क्ड एज यस. व्हाट इज द आंसर? आंसर इज 0 degree. द टोटल नंबर ऑफ पैरेलल इज यस. आंसर इज 181. द टू एंड पॉइंट्स ऑफ द एक्सिस ऑफ अ ग्लोब आर कॉल्ड द पोल्स. आवर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज इन विच कंट्री इज ग्रीनविच लोकेटेड. इन विच कंट्री इज ग्रीनविच लोकेटेड? व्हाट इज द राइट आंसर? आंसर इज इंग्लैंड. द पैरेलल्स एंड मेरिडियंस कट ईच अदर एट यस 90 degree. व्हाट इज द टोटल नंबर ऑफ इम्पॉर्टेंट पैरेलल्स ऑन द ग्लोब? यस, आवर राइट आंसर इज 7. द इक्वेटर इज मार्क्ड एज व्हाट इज करेक्ट आंसर? 0 degree latitude. Now our next exercise is fill in the blanks. The equator divides the earth into two parts called northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. The angular distance north or south of the equator is called latitude. The distance between two meridians is maximum at equator. The lines of longitudes are also known as the meridians. A grid on a map is the network of latitude and longitude. So student, this was our second chapter. Hope you understood. And for the question answer, you have to download PDF file from the SNCS site. And you have to write hard words and question answer in your classwork copy. Thank you student.